So good afternoon, friends. Today we are starting the lecture series on Introduction to Industrial Automation. It is an open elective offered in seventh semester of Electrical Engineering in Gujarat Technological University. The learning outcome of this is that the student will be able to define and explain concept of automation, and the student will be able to understand the importance of automation in industries after this lecture. What is an industry? We know that it's a place where some activity, some economic activity is going on. Some production is going on, some services are going on. So as per the standard definition, it is systematic economic activity of manufacturing a product or a service or trade. Now, main goal of this industry is to earn a profit. In this subject, we shall focus mainly on the manufacturing industries. Now, the word automation. The word automation is actually, if you look at the etymology or the origin of the word, is made up of two words, autos, that means self, and metro, that is moving. So automation means automatic, that is self-moving. So in short, the definition is, it is a set of technologies that results in operation of industrial machines and systems without significant human intervention. So here the key word is significant human intervention. This is the keyword over here, that human intervention is not there and achieves performance superior to manual operation. Right? So an arrangement, a set of technologies that results in operation of industrial machines without human intervention and achieves performance superior to human operation or manual operation. Right? So such a set of technologies are known as automation. The GIF on the right side of the screen, you can see that these machines are working on their own. There is no human intervention over here, and it is working better than what a human can do in a given situation, right? Now, what is the role of industry? So for that, what is the flow in an industry? So in an industry, a raw or unfinished material is processed. For that, you use energy, manpower, infrastructure. You apply some manufacturing process, you get finished product. So in this, at different levels, you can use automation. You can use automation so that the overall process is smooth and you get better product and you get better profit. Right? The profit equation for industries is very simple. You have a selling price per unit for a product minus cost per unit, and that is multiplied by the number of products, that is for production volume, and that is for profit. So now how does the automation comes into picture? So to get maximum profit, what is a common sense understanding that you need to increase selling price. I mean, competitive market, how can you increase selling price? Nobody is going to purchase your product if you increase selling price. Second is you have to do something so that your cost per unit is going down, but it is reduced, or you can produce the product at lesser price. So that is nothing but you have to increase the productivity, or you can increase your production in a given time, more number of products you are supposed to produce, assuming that yes, you have a market or demand to sell it. And that is going to result into profit. Any of this or all of this, if you do, then your profit is going to increase. Now, in subsequent slide, I am going to show you that industrial automation helps in doing or helps in achieving all of these three. So first is the cost per unit. What do we understand? That we are supposed to reduce the cost of per unit of material, which is our finished product. So now cost involves mainly material cost, energy cost, manpower cost, and infrastructure cost. Energy here I am referring as the other resources like water and other that is covered in energy. So raw material cost, if you use automated processes, it reduces waste, and so the material cost is reduced if you use industrial automation. If you use industrial automation, you can design it in an optimal way. They operate in a you can say optimal energy state, so that thereby you reduce the energy cost. Of course, when you use automatic machine, manpower requirement reduces, so their labor cost also reduces. And initially, to have an automated or robotic establishment, initial cost is high. But in a given time, you are able to better utilize the resources and have large production. So overall infrastructure cost goes down, right? So in short, cost per unit reduces in case of industrial automation. Now production volume. The production volume, that means number of products produced in a given stipulated time, in a day or in an hour or in a week. It depends on following factors. If you reduce production time, the production volume will increase. If you increase, reduce material handling time, the production volume is going to increase. So let's talk about the first. Production time is nothing but the time to produce the finished product. So when you have automated process automation, then all the operations are very well coordinated and you have a reduced production time. Material handling time is also reduced because large and heavy materials can be handled with very ease if you have automatic robotic arms or something like that. If they are handled by humans, it is going to be difficult. Idle time is also very less because machines, they do not get tired, so you don't have to allow for breaks and like that. So there is very less idle time, and so very highly coordinated operation is there. So there also you reduce the time. And quality assurance time. If you have a manual operations, and after every batch or repeatedly, you are supposed to see whether you are getting same quality or not. While in case of automated machines, you can assure a quality check for each and every product. And automatic rejection is also there if the product is not as per the quality. So that quality assurance time also reduces. So overall, the production volume is increased because of the reduction in production time, material handling time, idle time, and quality assurance time. Now, selling price. Obviously, price, you cannot afford to have more only if you have better quality. Now, automated products, they can have a better quality. And if you have a better quality product, you can afford to have a higher selling price. That is also possible with the help of industrial automation. In short, if you look at that particular profit equation, so you can reduce the selling, increase the selling price, reduce the cost per unit, increase the volume, and overall product and productivity or profit and productivity increases if you go for industrial automation, right? So in addition, industrial automation is also having following advantages. That productivity improves, quality of the product is better, greater consistency of the product, and flexibility in getting new updated products. If you want to have a new product, you just have to program or make some necessary changes in the automatic systems, and you can have a product with the new specifications. Safety of worker is also improved in a hazardous or a dangerous situation. You don't have to put your workers in the dangerous. You can use robots or automated machines for that. Cost per unit reduces and profit increases, that we have already discussed, and overall working conditions also improve, right? So these are the advantages because of which industrial automation is becoming very, very popular these days, right? So in this lecture, we have seen what is an industry, what is automation, and what is the role of automation industry and how it is advantageous, right? So in subsequent lectures, we are going to see the architecture of industrial automation, role of PLC and DCS, role of communication, that is Modbus, Profibus, etc. And that's all about the first unit of industrial automation, right? So that's all from my side in this first unit. See you in the subsequent lecture about the architecture of automation.